Hello students, I hope all of you are fine and healthy at home. We all are facing a very critical situation, still things need to be done. As you have entered in class 10th and it is a big challenging time for you to utilize this time wisely and fruitfully. Hope you will make best use of time. So we have tried to provide you online lessons so that you can prepare well, at least something you can do and you can learn properly. First of all, I want to tell you that we are having two books. So in poetry part, we have already covered 6 poems. Rest 4 we need to be done, we need to do. So in this video, I am providing you poem number 7, that is I Know Why the Caged Birds Sing. It is a poem composed by Maya Angelou. Before starting the explanation of the poem, I just want to give you an idea about the poet. The poem is composed by Maya Angelou, who was born in St. Louis, Missouri on April 4, 1928. She was an author, poet, songwriter, dancer, and above all, civil rights activist. She is best known for her 7 autobiographical books, including I Know Why the Caged Bird Sings, which was nominated for the National Book Award. In 2010, she was awarded the Presidential Medal of Freedom by President Barack Obama. As an African American, Angelou experienced first-hand racial prejudice and discrimination in Arkansas. She was closely associated with Martin Luther King Jr. She gave her voice for the freedom and the rights of the African Americans. Now, just have an idea of the poem. What is given actually? In the poem, I Know Why the Caged Bird Sings, Maya, like a free bird, she is not free. Actually, she is a black American. She is African American. So, she is feeling herself like a caged bird. The bars of her cage are racialism, insecurity, poverty, and discrimination. But no matter how strong these bars are, they cannot keep her from singing her protest and demand for freedom and equality with the white race. The caged bird in Maya Angelou's poem is angry. Though he has not known freedom, he is restless in the cage. He wants to be free like the free bird. He sings his protest and his song is heard on the distant hill. The poem is a contrast between a caged bird and a free bird. Obviously, the African American is represented by the caged bird. This line is to be noted. The African American is represented by the caged bird and the white race, white American, represented by the free bird. So, through this poem, this poem is unjust discrimination against the African Americans in the United States. America is the land of opportunities, but these opportunities are enjoyed by the white race, while the African Americans are kept out of them and are made to suffer in humiliation and poverty. Now, let us read the poem. I am reading the lines, then I will explain you the stanza. So, stanza number 1, a free bird leaps on the back of the wind and floats downstream till the current ends and dips his wing in the orange sun rays and dares to claim the sky. These are the lines of one stanza number 1. These lines presenting the poet's own feelings of freedom, and these lines are extracted just to show how pathetic situation the African Americans were having those days. Here the poetess describes the free bird, which is a metaphor for white American who enjoys the freedom to the full extent and also fulfills his dreams and aspirations which he nourishes in his heart. In these lines, the free bird is regarded as a true epitome of freedom. The free bird, which is suggestive of a white American, springs from the ground or the tree to take off its flight in the vast sky. it fully enjoys its flight by sitting on the back of air. You can see this in line number 3, off the back of the wind and floats downstream. It flies in the direction of the air current. It experiences moving and gliding freely through the air. It hovers over a stream of wind and floats downwards to where the current of the stream ends and the wind is calm. It dips its wings in the sea of orange sunlight. The bird is shown in a state of great tranquility. It has the freedom to move about wherever it desires. It is so utterly free and without restraints that it dares to claim the sky. The whole fragment is its one big home. So here in this stanza, the free bird represents the white race and their domination. The freedom of the bird in the natural habitat is shown. The free bird is untroubled, and with the help of the color imagery of orange rays, the effect heightens as orange is a color of color associated with glow and happiness. And you can see this line, last line, and dares to claim the sky. Here figure of speech hyperbole has been used. I hope stanza number 1 is clear to all of you. Still, if you have any doubt, then you can ask when we will meet in the class hours. Definitely, I will solve your doubts. So, let us start stanza number 2. I am reading the lines. But a bird that stalks down his narrow cage can seldom see through his bars of rage. His wings are clipped and his feet are tied, so he opens his throat to sing. In these lines, the poetess introduces the limitations set up upon the caged bird, which is the metaphor of African American, and how this affects the bird, as the bird is still proud and cries out for freedom. So in this stanza, the poetess contrasts the situation by presenting the image of a caged bird. The caged bird tries to go after its cage in vain. The cage is narrow and its metaphorical bars of rays. She is unable to move out of the bars of his rays. The caged bird is seen to be angry with its situation. It desires with all its heart to escape its plight. But the caged bird cannot see beyond this cage. Its wings are clipped, that is, its freedom is taken away. It cannot fly even if it desires to. Its feet are tied. A bird to the ground represents an image completely opposite to its true nature of flight. This represents the fact of alienation of the bird. But the most important thing is that despite being in this utterly despondent predicament, the caged bird opens its throat to sing. That seems to be only joy and achievement in life. In spite of this miserable condition, the caged bird is opening its throat to sing for the freedom. So in this stanza, you can see the tone is immediately and drastically changed from peaceful, satisfied and joyful to one that is dark, unnerving and even frustrating. The poetess felt this way in her own life. She wrote and sang and danced because it was her way of expressing her longing for freedom. So you can see in the line number 3 of this stanza, can seldom see through. In this, the figure of speech alliteration has been used. The caged bird is a metaphor for the poet. Maya Angelou herself and all those African Americans who faced discrimination, prejudices and slavish treatment during the time. So in this stanza you can see that how the poetess is very much sad, pathetic. So through this poem she wants to call out for freedom and is ready for the struggle, and she is struggling, the poetess is struggling, and she has struggled a lot for the freedom those days, And in contrast to a free bird, if caged bird cannot see beyond the bars of his narrow cage, he can just walk stiffly on the floor of his cage. His movements are restricted. His cage is narrow. He is very angry and frustrated on account of his anger and frustration. He is unable to see what is there beyond his cage. He does not know what freedom is. Why? Because his wings are clipped. His feet are tied. He has no freedom, but he knows his life is not what it ought to be. So he gives vent to his feelings in a sad song. Still, he is ready to cry for freedom. I hope stanza 2 is clear to all of you. Let's go through the third stanza. I'm reading the lines. The caged bird sings with fearful trill of things unknown but longed for still, and his tune is heard on the distant hill, for the caged bird sings of freedom. These are the lines. There are some words which you need to underline in this, like seldom is in another the earlier stanza. You need to underline some words like fearful trill, things unknown, longed for still, on the distant hill. I will let you know at the end of the video, at the end of the poem's explanation, you will get all the words with their meaning, so that you can note down easily. And while going through, while revising the poem, you can easily come to know the explanation part. So these lines I have read. Now let us have an explanation. So in this line, in this stanza, the poet is saying that despite his captivity and the loss of freedom, as you know that the that African Americans are like caged birds, so here the poetess has shown herself as a caged bird, and she is venting her voice through this sad song. So despite his captivity and the loss of freedom, the bird sings. Still, he sings in a shrill, warbling voice. Shrill, warbling voice. Fearful trill means shrill, warbling voice. He wants his freedom, though he has never experienced freedom. He does not know what freedom is, but he knows he is not happy in this present situation. He wants to change it. His song is heard on the distant hill, causing fear. He sings of freedom. So the poetess is trying to say that while singing, the caged bird's voice wavers. It sings of freedom, something it does not have. The idea of freedom is its dream, which can never be fulfilled or achieved. But it sings out of it. There is a fear in its voice. It has never known what freedom tastes like, but hopes to have it for its own. Its voice can be heard from distant places. When the bird sings for its freedom, it can be heard from the distant places, on hills where it inspires others to dream of freedom. The caged bird does not sing of sadness. Its song is not having a voice of sadness. In spite of that, it is having a feeling of hope, inspiration and freedom. In these lines, the poet clearly brings to us that the voice of the black Americans, who are badly tortured and exploited, can never be suppressed. Their voice for freedom and equality will be heard one day. No fear can waver them from their way, as they seem to be determined to achieve their freedom, which is the birthright to every human being. They firmly believe that one day they will succeed in breaking the shackles of slavery. Through this voice, they will be able to get freedom one day. Finally, throughout the poem, the poetess is trying to convey that through this song, they definitely will get freedom someday. So, dear students, we have covered three stanzas today in this video. And I hope all of you have understood, but you need to read it again. Please go through this, and if you have any doubt, please ask in next, even in next class or in next video, or when we will meet in our school classes, so then we can solve those problems. So I hope you have understood, and please read it again. After that, in the next video, I will meet with you. So have a nice day.